Are you a self-proclaimed nerd? Love creating automations and systems in your life that are essentially useless, but a lot of fun to do? Well, ladies and gentlemen, have I got a treat for you today. This is going to be the top 5 automations that you can implement in your personal life to achieve more with less today. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Ravi Abuvala, founder of Scaling With Systems, where we build profitable client acquisition systems and processes for our clients. And I have created literally thousands of automations in my lifetime, and I have enabled others to create tens of thousands. So I know a thing or two when it comes to the automation and system world. But that being said, most of the automations and systems I create, well, they're around business. And business can sometimes be boring. So this video is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to show you some personal zaps that you can set up in your life in order to be more efficient today. Now, before I dive into my screen here, I need to tell you that the software that I'll be using in this video to show you these automations is something called Zapier, Zapier. I have 3 or 4 additional videos on Zapier where I walk you through exactly how to come into Zapier as a beginner and set up automations that can help your company scale. I also show you the top 20 Zaps that we use inside of our 8-figure company in order to grow it. So if you've never used Zapier before, this may be a little confusing. So make sure you either watch those videos first or you watch them after you watch this one. With all that out of the way, let's dive right in. So the first Zap that you can use inside of your business is a forecast or weather Zap. So if you come into Zapier, you can actually make the trigger event be today's forecast, and then you can actually put in your latitude and longitude. So this is my latitude and longitude for Miami, and then it can actually spit out to your Slack channel a notification on the daily basis of what your weather is like. And I actually fly planes, I'm a private pilot, so I actually like to know what the weather is on a daily basis, and sometimes I can't be bothered to open up the blinds and look outside. Don't be ridiculous, why would I do that when I have automation here? So this is actually what it looks like. I have it, the username that it sent to me inside of Slack is to me. I have it under the summary, it tells you it's clear throughout the day today. I put the high and the low, and then I put the chance of rain, and I call it the weather bot. And actually, if I pull up my Slack channel for you really quickly, and as you can see here, I just did a test and here's my weather bot. Today is going to be clear throughout the day. You got a high of 78 degrees and a low of 72 degrees. You gotta love Miami, and a chance of rain of 12%. Now, moving on to the second useless but somewhat fun automation you can set up in your personal life. This one I call the good sun automation. Now, this is an automation where the trigger is going to be when an event starts in your Google Calendar. So I've set up my Google Calendar for my email address here. I set up the trigger is going to be my calendar 36 hours before this event starts, and the event is called Mom's Birthday. So 36 hours before I have my mom's birthday in my Google Calendar is going to be the trigger. And then if we come down here to direct message, we can actually have it send a direct message specifically in Slack to my executive assistant. So I have it to Shannon, which is my executive assistant, and the message says, please buy my mom flowers, it's her birthday tomorrow, exclamation point. I call it the great sun bot, like I talked about earlier, and I can test it and send it over to her Slack so that 36 hours every year before my mom's birthday, I get a notification sent to my executive assistant to buy my mom flowers, so they're waiting at the door for my mom that day. Now, onto the third personal automation you can set up in your life. This one may actually be a little bit useful. If you've watched my other videos that I've talked about on how I've deleted all the social media apps from my phone, but still have a social presence online, then you'll know that I don't really have Instagram or Facebook or YouTube or LinkedIn actually on my phone. And so in order for me to be able to see when my team posts a piece of content so that I can respond back to all of the comments, I've set up an automation inside of Zapier here where Instagram is the app. And then when new media is posted in my account, I chose my account and then I send a message to me inside of Slack called the content bot. And it actually puts the hyperlink to that Instagram post. So if I was to pull up my Instagram again, you can see right here, the content bot, here's the thumbnail. And then if I click on the Instagram post, it pulls it up on my desktop computer so I don't have to log in on my phone. Now, for the fourth personal automation or Zap that I actually recommend setting up, if you know anything about me, you know that I absolutely hate checking emails. I actually haven't checked any emails in about 3 years. I have my team members or my executive assistant check emails for me on a daily basis because I couldn't think of something that would be a bigger waste of my time. That being said, there are conversations that I do want to keep tabs on inside my email inbox, but I don't want to have to go to the hassle of opening up my mail app or opening up my Gmail and then be distracted by the hundreds of different different emails inside of there. So for our fourth personal automation that I have set up in here, you can actually get a notification inside of your Slack channel, which is where I pretty much live my life, is inside Slack, when you get an email from somebody or with a specific subject line, so that you don't have to go and open up the email app itself. So the trigger is going to be whenever your Gmail, whenever you get a new email matching search, then I actually have it from Mike Long, which was the gentleman that I purchased my plane from. So one of the things that I set up in here was that I bought a Piper Cherokee 6 recently. It's an absolute beautiful six-seater plane because I'm a pilot, and I didn't want to have to deal with all these conversations going on over email, but I didn't want to have to give somebody my personal phone number. So what this allowed me to do was keep tabs of the conversations going on inside of my Slack channel, and I could respond back there and my assistant could see what to say back to them. And then once I got the email from Mike, then I would send an email to myself called the plane bot on this one specifically, so I knew what the conversation was about. And then if I show you guys what that looks like inside Slack, you can see right here, plane bot, and then here's the conversation that Mike and I are having together. And for our fifth and final personal automation or zap, some of you may think I have gone a little overboard, but I frankly don't care. This is actually one that I have set up on a weekly basis because every single Sunday, my girlfriend is kind enough to make me my smoothies for the week. So that if you know anything about me, you know I love efficiency. Whenever I get up out of my desk at about 12 o'clock and have my first smoothie for the day, all I have to do is walk to my refrigerator, get the smoothie out, and plug it in, and it will automatically start blending. None of that silly time spent pouring berries in or pouring egg whites or pouring in any protein powder. But sometimes my girlfriend, although incredible, is human and she forgets. So what I have done here is set up an automation so that every Sunday, so you have the trigger be at a specific time, every Sunday at 8 a.m., I send an email to my girlfriend's email address. And what I say is, it's from the name is Love of Your Life. That's where she gets it from. The subject is don't forget. And then the body says, hello, beautiful. Don't forget to make my smoothies today so I can be big and strong this week. Love, Ravi. P.S. Please don't leave me. Now, I cannot guarantee here just as a formality that your girlfriend or significant other will not leave you if you do send them email reminders to make you food. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, five totally useless and pointless automations and systems you can set up in your personal life if you have nothing better to do. Now, if you do want to learn how to seriously set up Zapier and automations inside your business for scale, you should check out one of the other two videos on your screen here, which is going to walk you through the beginner's guide to setting up Zapier in your business, and then also the top 20 Zapier automations that we use inside of our company for scale. Don't forget to like, comment down below, and smash the subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in those videos.